An incident from this weekend is getting some national attention after an angry parent punched an umpire at a Mississippi 12-year-old softball game.
That's right. Stephen Pimpo spoke with the Lowndes County Recreation Director and a veteran umpire about why outbursts at youth sporting events are driving potential officials away.
Andrea Winston, that's right. According to our news partner WLBT, an umpire was calling a softball game in Laurel when a parent who was removed from the park allegedly attacked her after the game. Lowndes County Recreation Director Roger Short told me that officials know there's always the possibility for volatile situations, but many umpires are in it for the love of the game, and fighting angry parents is not what they signed up for. Umpire Christy Moore was left with a black eye and bruises after an angry mother allegedly punched her in the face following a 12-year-old softball game in Laurel Saturday night.
Sadly as it is, it's becoming more commonplace than we would like to see.
Moore later took to social media warning parents how this kind of behavior is a big reason for the nationwide shortage of youth umpires and could lead to more empty ballparks. Lowndes County Recreation Director Roger Short agrees.
It's not only contributing to the shortage of umpires in the youth sports, it's also contributing to the shortage of umpires at high school level. I've dealt with high school sports for many, many years.
Short says that when he first started as an assigning secretary for high school baseball, they'd average about 80 umpires per season. When he retired 3 years ago, that number went down to 50. WCBI meteorologist Lance Blocker is also a certified umpire who's called games from Little League to college baseball off and on for over 10 years. He says he's seen it all.
I've been escorted off the field by the State Patrol, Georgia State Patrol, because of issues from parents where they were throwing stuff on a field one time because of a close call, people yelling death threats at you. We're going to meet you at your car.
Blocker says prospective officials start out and learn by calling games at the youth level. But the abuse from parents and coaches gets in the way.
These parents and coaches don't give them that opportunity to learn. They yell at them, they cuss at them, they call them all sorts of names, and they're not more than 3 or 4 years older than the kids they're umpiring.
Short says Lowndes County is fortunate to have a regular supply of veteran umpires.
If I've got 8 umpires that are available, I'm in good shape.
But while their numbers have remained steady, they're not seeing that next generation of younger officials.
We're all getting older, you know, and honestly, I don't have a lot of new umpires that are jumping into bits.
Beyond that, Short says that parents should keep in mind the kind of example they're setting.
Parents, do you want your kids to mimic what you may be doing and the way you may act toward umpires?
Short tells me they are actively trying to recruit that next generation of umpires, reaching out to high school baseball and softball players who won't play in college but still want to be involved with the game.